And I'm Little Froggy.
And today we are in the city for a little doll photography. Let's go. Right now it is 8 o'clock.
So we have about an hour until the sun starts setting.
So we kind of got to be fast. We better find a good location to take some great photos. I really like the way this railing looks, so we're gonna try to capture some of that architecture in this photo. Okay, so right now we're gonna get a photo that we can use as a backdrop later. So I'm gonna take a photo with no one in it, no dolls, no nothing. And right now the street is clear, so this is my chance. If I get you to scoot over, just a little bit. All right, here we go. I wanna get that railing in the shot.
This is a perfect night to catch a cold.
With more lighting. It's getting darker and the street lights are coming on and it's giving everything like this yellow glow. So right here we have more like sky above us. Hopefully we'll get better pictures.
Listen to old songs and headphones. Don't wanna wake up tomorrow. I know a place where you like to go.
Pretty shot of Chloe. The light is beautiful. We can see all the details in her face, and it looks like she's walking down the street.
Exactly.
I like using sidewalks in the photos because it helps to give a point of like perspective. You can see that it's wide up front and it gets farther away. So I think that will give our photos a little bit more dimension. Using little tiny props really does help to sell the idea that the dolls are the right size. So we're gonna use this little puppy in the photo with Chloe to help it look like, you know, she's our size.
It's a beautiful night here where we are. Let's make our moon tonight and ride today.
I think we have enough footage to go home and make some cool printables. So let's see what we got. I am back in the studio and we printed out one of the pictures that we took. I enlarged it so it spans over 3 pieces of paper. We are going to use these to make a backdrop for our doll photography. This way we can take city pictures anytime we like. I carefully cut off the margin on the sides so the pieces can overlap and fit together. Fold a piece of poster board in half, cut it to make 2, glue the printables onto the top of the poster board, and for me, it leaves a large blank space underneath. But that is not a problem since we are using this as a backdrop. To help the backdrop stand up, bend it to make a semicircle, make a few props by taking sticks, gluing them to 2 popsicle sticks, glue artificial plants to the top, to make a tree. I am going to make a street lamp to go with our street scene using recycled paper, a mini flashlight that I found at the dollar store, a ping pong ball, paint, a wooden dowel, and glue. I start by taking recycled paper, and I like using graded homework because we have so much of it. And this is a great way to recycle. Take a wooden dowel and place it at the end of the paper.
Curl the paper over the wooden dowel, making sure the ends are tucked under, then begin to roll. If my roll is not as tight as I would like, I unroll it and go again, making sure that it is straight on the ends, then roll it all the way to the end of the paper. Remove the wooden dowel to pre-roll the paper so it has a nice curl. Gently unroll the paper, place the end of the flashlight inside the curl, and roll it again. Use glue to secure the ends to make a paper tube large enough to fit the flashlight. Take another piece of paper, add glue to one side, place the tube on the edge, and roll it to add another layer. Glue down the end to make the tube a little stronger. We are making the paper tube to hold the flashlight so we can have a street lamp that actually lights up. I'm going to remove this hook here because this is actually a keychain. Then take a ping pong ball and cut a hole in the bottom. Now this ping pong ball I found at the grocery store. It's like a dollar. The cheaper, the better. The good quality ping pong balls tend to shatter, whereas the inexpensive ones will allow you to cut through them. And remember to always have adult supervision when working with sharp objects. Take care not to cut the opening too large so that it can fit onto the flashlight. Then turn it on to make sure it works. Yay! I want to place this at the top of the paper tube, but we might need something inside to help keep it stable. So I roll another paper tube using the wooden dowel, adding a few layers so it can fit inside of the other paper tube. With the flashlight at the other end, we have about 2 inches hanging out. So I cut strips of paper and begin wrapping them around the end. When I get the widths to match, it will look like one long paper tube. I want to add a little bit of detail, so I cut wider strips of paper and begin wrapping them around the end of the tube. I started with a 3-inch strip of paper, then I added a 2.5, then 1 inch, and each time I'm adding about 4 strips of paper. Then I add a 1/2 inch strip of paper around the bottom. I added 7 of those, and all of this paper at the bottom is adding weight to help it stand up. I added a strip of paper around the top, then pushed it up to meet the edge of the ping pong ball to make the pole and base for our street light. Remove the flashlight and ping pong ball. Using acrylic paint, I paint it black. Once it's dry, turn on the flashlight, add the ping pong ball, place the flashlight inside the tube to make a working street lamp. Add the street lamp to the scene to make a city background at home for a little doll photography.
And you're done.
Happy crafting!
Give a shout out to Halvin. What's up? Sophie, you'll never guess what I just found.
A cocoa latte. No, a new pair of shoes.
Nope, a puppy. Can I keep it?
Are you sure you wouldn't rather have a cocoa latte?
Ew, I'm gonna call you Slimer. You can sleep on Sophie's bed.
Hey!
Just kidding.